take you through the solo in Black Cat by Janet Jackson. And it was also requested that I show a couple of the little verse licks that Nuno Bettencourt did on, I think it was just the video mix, because it's not on the album version. But it was the video mix is the one I did my cover on. And it's been one of my favourite covers to do, so it's nice to go back and relearn this stuff, because it's really fun. So I'll tell you what, I'll start with those verse riffs or verse licks, because I think they're pretty good once you get up to speed with them. They just might need a little bit of explanation. But the first one is this little cool hammer-on and triplet lick. Let me get in the groove. It'll be kind of after the main riff, something like... So it's this bit. It sounds a lot more fancy than what it is probably, but I think the main thing to kind of get into grips with this is to ingrain in your head that it's a triplet feel, you know, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, you know. So you're just basically hitting the open strings of E, A and D, then afterwards you're hammering on with the 5 and 7. It's something I like to do if you're just sitting with the guitar not really doing anything, just practicing building up your hammer on pull off strength. You know, it feels pretty good, and once you get up to the triplet speed and locking in the synchronization, that should be a piece of cake, really. Another thing that it does, which maybe deserves a little bit more explanation, is he does something like this. It's essentially just pinch harmonics. What we're doing is we're hitting the fourth of the G string, bending it up, and we're playing pinch harmonics. And when you play them on different parts of the string, you create different pinch harmonics, essentially. So that's how you get that sound. So I'm starting closer to the bridge and moving up, and you create this kind of sound. Now, I've mentioned a couple of times, I think, in live streams about the way I approach pinch harmonics, and I don't know if it's going to show up here, but if you can see the way I'm holding my pick, I don't show a lot of pick, really, so this might help me. But you can see the pick is pointing up that way, and my thumb is pointing up that way, and in between you kind of have a V shape. That's where I rest the string, like in my finger here, in that V, and that's how I think I produce the pinch harmonic. I think there might be other techniques available, but that's what I do. It took me a while before I could do them on demand, and when I could finally do it, I found I couldn't not do pinch harmonics. So if you can't do them just yet, don't worry too much about it. It should come in time, and maybe look at other tutorials as well, because my method might not work for you. What else was I gonna go over? Yes, there was one more, which is, I'll put a link in because it's a technique I've already covered in another video, but he does this. And to save some time, I won't explain that any further, but he's just hammering on, pulling off the second off the G and sliding up his flesh. But if you don't know how to do that, I mean, I'm not sure what it's called, but I'll link the video of how I explain that technique. Okay, so onto the main solo now. And with everything, I'm referencing the notation I made quite a while ago, which is on my Patreon. So what I'll do is I'll play through it slowly, and I'll link the video at the start of the solo so you can hear how it should sound. But I'll play it slowly, and I'll stop on the techniques that I think deserve a little more explanation. So if I just kind of go through the first part, it's something like this. Okay, I understand that actually wasn't slow, but let me just explain that and then try and play it slow again. So there's a couple points there, I think, which are quite hard. Well, not hard, but these tips might help. We're starting off with a natural harmonic on the third fret. And whenever I'm playing a harmonic around there, that's not like the 5, 7 or 12 harmonics, I depress my whammy bar. And I feel by doing that just before hitting the harmonic, it helps them ring out cleaner. rather than just hitting them. I mean, you might not hear if there's a difference there. Maybe I don't hear a difference, but I feel a lot better depressing the whammy bar than going for that harmonic. Okay, so that's the first part. This lick here, starting on the 17th of the high E, I really like this as a little like chromatic lick, because we're pitting 17, 16, 15, 14. It's a lick you'd hear like Steve Lukather do, or even Jay Graydon. And what's maybe quite tricky about this, apart from this little... I mean, you might find that's quite hard to do straight away if you're not used to using your pinky. But it's the way you might have to change your hand positions or fret positions just like in the middle of it. So I start off with my home position being on the 14th fret, so that's where my first finger lies, and the others follow accordingly. So you pull off from 17, 16, 15, 14. And when I get to that 15th off the high E again, that's when I move my whole hand position up, so I can hit that 17th of the high E in a comfortable bend. Okay, something like that. Then you have a 1.5 bend on that 17th of the B. Okay, then afterwards it's something like... So here's a cool lick here. I say this is like a full slide guitar technique. We're bending the 10th up full step, and as we release, we're actually hitting the beat. Now the way I'm doing that, I naturally find if I was to bend the 10th fret of the high E, the B string is gonna get stuck under my finger as well. So all I need to do is just pick the B on the way down. You might want to think about muting the high E string when you do that though. To do that, I'm using the flesh of my first finger here. So I'm like rolling, let's see, bring this to the angle. So like when I'm going on the B, I'm rolling my hand out like that, so I'm just fretting the B on the way down. Okay. Hopefully that's a good little tip there. And let's see, after that we do something like... Okay, that should be self-explanatory. Similar idea again with that slide bend. Okay, another really cool lick, this tapping part. So we're mainly just, we're gonna be hammering on from the 8th of the B to the 10th. And we're gonna be tapping the 20th, the 19th, 17th, 16th, and 15th. Now whenever you're doing tapping, the big thing I try and focus on it is muting the other strings. Because if I wasn't focused on muting the other strings, you'd be hearing everything, I think, popping out. So to do that, you see my middle fingers protruding quite a lot. That's muting the G, the D, and the A string. And when I'm tapping, this part of my hand here is muting the low E string. That's what I'm resting on when I'm tapping. So hopefully, if you get a good muting technique, you can make the taps ring out pretty well. And if I try and not use those muting techniques, let's see what it sounds like. Well, I got lucky there, but usually you'd hear a lot of noise. The lick after that is also pretty cool. Something like... I find that really hard to do though, doing that little bend on the 10th of the B. Then you're going straight to harmonic on the 7th of the B and the G. Again, you need to think about muting techniques and getting that finger over to cleanly hit that harmonic. Okay, that might take some time. Then the last lick. Okay, so something like that. It's pretty self-explanatory though. And then a little lick after doing that's kind of full slide thing again. Okay. So yeah, so there's maybe three or four licks in there which I'd say needed a bit more explanation. But like with everything, you just need to slow it down, get your fingers used to what you're doing, because I mean, when I was learning this solo, some of these techniques were quite new to me, and you know, I couldn't play them straight away. So give them a go. If you're struggling with anything, practice a bit more, then take a break and come back to it. Let the muscle memory build up. Then hopefully it should become easier over time. But apart from that though, I hope that helps. And I hope you enjoy playing it, because I certainly did. Cheers.